Actually, what I see here, when I entered here, the first thing that I told one of the people who are here is that I can't believe it. Because just the other day I was in Los Angeles, and I happened to hear about a museum downtown in Los Angeles. It's called The Broad. And that museum forever has long lines of the youth going into the museum. And we were asking ourselves, why is this different from what we have probably in Africa, or probably what we have here? And just maybe to, there's an article here which was actually written about the Broad Museum, and the title of the write-up is, What's Drawing Millennials to Downtown LA Broad Museum? What I see here, three quarters of the people that I see here are what we call the millennials. The millennials are the youth, very energetic people with so many creative ideas. And what a better place to see them than here and this afternoon. And the article actually says the line is long and chatty, thick with restless, tattooed 20-somethings, but here I see even less than 10 years and younger. And the reason why the Broad is such a hit for the youth in downtown LA, it's that whatever is inside the museum is colorful, edgy art, and it identifies with the youth. What actually I see here is exactly the same thing as the Broad. Today I know, I think at the University of Nairobi, there is a discussion by the Minister of Tourism, together with a few other people, about how East Africa, and more so Kenya, can come up with a Broad. A museum that will be catchy to the youth, a museum that will identify with the youth. In Kenya today, I think 70% of the people are the youth. And we have to keep up with that trend. Otherwise, if we keep on putting up the old, similar, same things, I can tell you that we will not be getting the crowds and the audiences that we so desire. The National Museums of Kenya has been there for 100 and plus years, and it's only now that we are starting to see a lot of changes within most of our museums. And this is an example of the changes that we want to see. If I may just ask, maybe most of you, or because I can see most of the people here are the children, who is your hero? Who is your hero? Can you say your hero? Or your Shujaa? No, not the people, not whatever is here. Do you have someone that you think is a hero, or a Superman, from what you see in TV? Probably for most of us, like maybe my age and other people who may understand, if you ask me who my hero is, probably I would say it's my mother, it's my father, or someone that you identify with. Somebody that has done things that you admire. Things that go beyond maybe what just ordinary people do. And we should all be heroes. None of us should be left behind as a hero. Because in whichever little way you impact on someone, you are already a hero. And this is what we are celebrating in this exhibition. These are heroes that probably we identify with them in terms of maybe what they did during their times in their communities, freedom fighting and all those other things. But even today we have heroes. And I'm sure like if you think a little bit, you might even identify and say maybe somebody in your classroom who came and gave you maybe some water, or who gave you a pen, or who you just admire because of the deeds that they have. Those are the heroes that we want to celebrate. So mine really is to say that let us move with the times, and we welcome like even all the youth who are here. If you have an idea and you feel that that is what you want to see in the National Museums of Kenya, in terms of all the exhibitions or wherever else you are, please bring it forth to us so that we can be able to work with you. So mine is to thank the young gentlemen here. We wish you all the best, and we work with you, we work with you. And actually, you are the ones who are even enhancing our products. And so we want to work with you and even take some of these exhibitions to other places so that people can be able to appreciate and see that we have changes.